Hey folks, I finally made it. I am able to flash OS for this Chipsee RK3568 panel PC in my Windows, in my Mac, and in my Linux. The tricky part is to use an up-to-date closed source upgrade tool program. My good buddy emailed me a latest version in June 2023. I wasn't able to find it anywhere on the internet. It finally made everything I'll show you later possible. To be honest, I tried a lot of times and I failed a lot of times. In a previous video, I said I wasn't able to flash OS on my Mac. I read a lot of tutorials before and after that video. Those tutorials were written by many board makers and maybe copy-pasted here and there. They all claim to be working, some of them are really complicated. But now I'm gonna tell you it's no more than two lines of commands in Mac or Linux to flash an OS. After 2 minutes and a half, even if your devices were bricked, they shall get back to life with a auto-factory OS. I will show you how it's done in three sections, for Windows users, Mac users, and the Linux users respectively. You can jump to the section in the timeline below. Let's begin. So whatever OS your workstation is running, the first step is common. You need to connect a USB Type-C cable, one side on this Chipsee RK3568 PC, and the other side to your workstation. This is a 7-inch model I'm showing. You can find a Type-C port on any RK3568 product models. And then before powering up the Chipsee device, you need to press and hold this PROG button. Then you plug in the power cord and hold the PROG button for 2 or 3 seconds. If you see the screen is black, then you are good to go. If you see the device boots into a desktop system, then you might need to do it again. And then let's go to our workstation. So in Windows, we use RK Dev tool. Be sure to install the driver assistant first. You can find all these on Chipsee docs site. Then you go straight to upgrade the firmware type, click to choose a Chipsee pre-built image. Don't forget to decompress. The extension should be .img and not .xz. Then click upgrade, then wait for your Chipsee PC to boot to system automatically. The time is now 7:56 PM. Let's see how long it takes. I'll fast forward for you. After the flashing finishes, it's 7:59 PM. Pretty quick, huh? Next, let's check out how to flash in Mac. No matter if you are using an Intel Mac or an Apple Silicon M1 Mac, they should all work, with a little trick, of course. You can run upgrade to LD, which means list devices, and you should see your device is in MASKROM mode, and then you run upgrade to UF, which means upload firmware on the Chipsee's pre-built image. Don't forget the .slash, which means a file in the current directory. And that's it. You can wait 3 minutes and should be good to go. I have tested this program on a M1 Mac Mini, which is also my work machine. Even if the binary upgrade tool program provided by Rockchip is compiled against x64 architecture, I can use Rosetta 2 to execute this program. If you are running an M1 or M2 or newer Apple Silicon Mac, you can confirm it by uname-m, and it should be ARM64. But if you are working on an Intel Mac, it will display x86-64. For Intel Mac users, you can run the upgrade tool directly, but if you are working on an M1 Mac like mine, then you would need Rosetta to run this program. You can install Rosetta with software update, install Rosetta, then you are good to go. At last, let's help our Linux users. You will need an Intel or AMD Linux PC. Because the upgrade tool is closed sourced and provided in an x64 architecture from Rockchip. I know there is an open sourced tool called RK Develop Tool, but since the image Chipsee provided is in Rockchip firmware format, which the RK Develop Tool does not support. As far as I know, the RK Develop Tool only supports raw firmware format. So we have no choice but to run this program on x64 Linux PC. Make sure you press the DPROG button when powering up the device, and you can check this by entering RS-USB. You should see a Rockchip USB device. Then you can use sudo upgrade to LD, which means list devices, and you should see RK3568 device in this MASKROM mode. Next, let's upload the firmware by sudo upgrade to UF, our pre-built image, and that's it. Wait for 3 minutes and your device should be booted to desktop automatically. Be sure to use sudo, otherwise even if the command is executable, the command does not behave correctly. And finally, we can flash OS for this Chipsee RK3568 PC on all three mainstream operating systems. No matter if you want to flash Android, Debian, or Buildroot Qt Linux, no matter if your RK3568 is a 5-inch product, a 7-inch product, or a product with 10-inch or above panel, the procedure is all the same. I hope people with only a Mac or a Linux can find this video useful, because not everybody has a spare Windows machine on his desk, just like me. If you like the content I produce, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Gaofeng, thanks for watching, see you next time.